Hey guys, in this video I'm showing you the best deck for the Super Lava Hound Challenge and also what is my opinion about the new card. If you guys know, feel free to press like button and for sure also to subscribe the channel. And I would say we are playing this Lava Hound deck today. It's a hybrid between a sheep Lava Hound deck and also a Lava Hound deck which is good against the other Lava Hound cards. We are using the Executioner because Executioner is so broken. Also the Electro Dragon, the Mega Minion, and we are using actually so many sheep cards to actually cycle as fast as possible back to the new Super Lava Hound, because as more often you can play the Lava Hound, the better it is, because you can use the Lava Hound more often. So we're going in with the Super Lava Hound, and firstly you have to actually understand the card to counter the card. So actually never defend the troops like this, because actually when the Lava Hound is dying, the Lava Hound is spawning fireball range or fireballs like that. So always go in with your Electro Dragon or with your other troops like that. Also Electro Spirit is going in, also the Ice Spirit is going in, so I'm hopefully surviving, and you guys can see actually how much damage the Super Lava Hound is dealing. It's so insane, and we're already in a such a high elixir, or I mean in a damage lead. I think we're going to get the tower down, but I'm not sure yet, and we're also having actually the next Lava Hound back. And as I said, it's important to actually abuse the Super Lava Hound, to play the Super Lava Hound pretty often, because every time it's feeling so great. So playing the Snowball, playing also the Snowball was kind of failed by myself, but it's not that important, because the most important thing is that actually our Lava Hound is not, or his queen is not locking onto our tower. Electro Dragon is going behind, and yeah, I think the Electro Dragon will get a chain, so the princess is also going to get down, but I'm not sure. Ah, okay, the princess got down by the fireballs, by the way. That's pretty great, and we're having actually already back the next Lava Hound, so we just can go in with the Executioner like that, and we are instantly ready with the next Lava Hound, and for sure, especially in a double time, it's so important to spam the Lava Hounds. Electro Spirit is just going in, but actually we don't need to defend more. We could play the Electro Spirit, didn't knew actually that the Executioner won't get any more hits out of that. But just the next Lava Hound is going in. He's having a lot of air counters, so he's taking this series pretty serious. But just playing actually these kind of cards, and we should have the next Super Lava Hound back in the cycle. So next Super Lava Hound is just going in, and that's looking great. Look at the death bomb. Look at the death bomb of this Super Lava Hound. Look at it, and look how everything is just dying. The Super Lava Hound is also dealing onto the Inferno Dragon, and now, oh crap, let's go. The tower will not get down actually, but it's fine. Look how many air counters he has, but look how easy it is still for us to actually claim to get the tower down. And yeah, I think that's already it for the first game. I think we could also take the free crown, but not sure. Yeah, we can take the free crown also against queen, against Inferno Dragon, against the Baby Dragon, against Princess. What a great deck. So just actually use the Lava Hound, and just use actually counters against air, or use fast cards to cycle back to the next Lava Hound. And yeah, I'm interested about your opinion. What is your opinion about the Super Lava Hound? Is it fun for you personally to play the new card? For me personally, it's a lot of fun, but it's feeling kind of bad for me personally that I can't play this new card just in a challenge. Yes, I know the card would be too strong to play it in ladder, for sure. I'm accepting that, I'm dealing with that. But I would have preferred a bigger challenge, maybe a 50 win challenge, maybe also a competitive challenge would be great. Anyways, I'm not complaining. I don't want to be a person who's always complaining about everything and can't be happy with the things I'm getting. But yeah, maybe you guys can agree with my opinion. Did you want it also a bigger challenge? Because in my opinion, yeah, it is a cool challenge. For sure, it's also the most funniest challenge for me 2022. It was more fun than the arena challenge. But still, I wanted something more, because yeah, actually it's a Lava Hound, and I'm a Lava Hound player, so maybe next time we can get more, but still cool event. Otherwise I wouldn't have played actually any event, just playing the event because of the super lava hound. And we're now going and again with the next lava hound. And yeah, we are in the damage lead. We are just in the damage lead. I'm not really sure, but I think just actually the lava hound took this kind of damage. Electro dragon is going in, ice bird is going in, electro spirit is going in, and we can't get the shade unfortunately. But we can take the tower, the troops down by the fireball. That's looking so crazy. Why am we doing so much death damage? It's crazy. One lava hound is tanking for the other lava hounds. Also, the pups are dropping off, and we already took the second tower down. And he's playing Dark Goblin Inferno Tower. But you guys can see actually that these aren't really the real counters against our deck because of the super lava hound death bomb. Now we're going in with the electro dragon like that. As I said, don't play your troops in front of the electro dragon, just play them behind, because actually the death bomb is just in front of the super lava hound. Ice bird is going in, and now electro spirit is going in, and I think now it's time for the electro dragon. It's looking like he is actually able somehow to defend us, but let's see. Yeah, we were able to defend him. That's actually pretty cool. So we don't have actually the pressure to take his tower down, but I think I'm going in now with the executioner. Oh, electro executioner was wasted by my side. Anyways, it's time for the super lava hound, and we are saying we just actually lost the tower for the content, guys. Electro dragon is going in, ice bird is going in, and now we're going in with this one as well. And yeah, I think it will be actually the free crown. Pretty sure it will be the free crown. So let's see how he is going to defend that. Executioner is not looking onto the king tower. That's kind of unlucky, but it's fine. And it's time for the next super lava hound. And yeah, I think the next super lava hound will actually give us the win. But not really sure if I'm right. I mean, his Inferno Tower and his Dark Goblin is pretty strong against us. Okay, Mega Minion is going in. Electro Spirit. When did I outcycle him? Super Lava Hound is going in right now. When did I actually outcycle him? I'm pretty interested. Maybe already now. Actually, the Super Lava Hound will also take a lot of death bomb onto his tower. It was around about 200, I guess. And now just cycling actually the next Super Lava Hound. Already getting the next Super Lava Hound death bomb for sure. But, I think not. Nah, not really sure. I think the Lava Hound is too far from the tower array, but next lava hounds are onto the tower. And you guys can see he's playing the queen, he's playing the Dark Goblin, he's playing the Inferno Tower, but I am still able to make a lot of chip damage onto his king tower and still able to actually take his tower down. And yeah, I think you guys understand slowly how you should play this deck, and I think also you understand slowly why this deck is so broken. He's using, as I said, Inferno Dragon, Fireball, Inferno Tower, I mean, Fireball, Dart Goblin, Queen, but we are still taking a lot of ship damage. Now we just have to cycle back to our next super, or our first super lava hound actually. And let's see actually how we can deal with them. Unfortunately, the lava hound is the last card, but it's still fine. Super lava hound is going instantly in when we are having actually the super lava hound ready. And let's see how he is dealing with that. We could go in with the dragons, but we also just could go in like that. And just could go in like that. Also could just play the next ice bird for the reset. I think it's so worth it for just one elixir to keep the Inferno Dragon nearly completely alive. Megaman is going in, and the fire spirit to keep my executioner for sure at life. And I think the executioner will stay at life, or will it? Yes! Great snowball, great reaction time for us also. And the executioner is dealing the whole time actually the ship damage at the back, and we already took the tower down in just 1 minute of playtime. Even we had to cycle to the lava hound, so we threw I think 5 elixir, but not sure. And then we still got the tower down in the first minute. That's so crazy. Super lava hound is going in as well. Again, ice bird is also ready. but we won't take actually the King Tower down. We didn't have to play the Lava Hound, but I just thought about, hey, is he maybe giving up? But he isn't giving up. He is giving his best for sure, as we guys can see. Electro Dragon is going, Executioner is going in. Oh, the timing, guys. The timing is great. And also the Eye Electro Spirit was great. Let's go, guys. And yeah, in my opinion, try this deck out and feel free. Trust me, guys. I'm so interested. What's your opinion about the Super Lava Hound? So please write it me down in the comments. And yeah, that's it with the deck. See you next video. Bye, guys.